kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now let's head down to the coin toss, and brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calorie. Enjoy everything. Georgia Tech will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. Fielded at the four. And he's tackled at the 28. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. The middle. That'll make it second and four. It's second and four to go. Ball on their own 34. Knocked out of bounds. The 37-yard line. Six-yard line.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. And he's taken down at the 49. First down.
Here we go, check. Eagle.
He gets to about the 31-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Down at the 20-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. He's tackled right around the 18-yard line. So the quarterback keeps it for 2 yards.
This is a pretty good play here by the junior safety stepping up and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 18-yard line.
Here we go.
Tackle at the 16. Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Why in the world would the offense run a route short of the first down? That just baffles me every time I see that.
Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Air Force is looking to go up by 3. It's up. And it hits the upright. No good. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He has some room. He's to the 40. And he's tackled right around the 50.
That's always a big blow to a defense to give up a long run like that. We'll see a lot of those guys hanging their head.
So it's first and 10 after the big run.
Hey, that's good. That's good.
He makes it to the 48-yard line. He holds on to it and gets maybe 2 yards. That makes it 7-8.
Watch 20, check 20. I got it.
He's at the 30. Tackle made at the 24. From the 24-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop at the 26-yard line.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. From the 28-yard line, third down. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. He was that close to making a big play.
His safety is kicking himself for dropping that.
Launches one for the end zone. He's got it. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. And he converts the extra point. A 7-play, 80-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
The score now, 7-0. They line up to kick this one away. Taken at the 5. And he's taken down at the 31. Yellow Jackets are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. A man down, and he's in some pain right now. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. The Yellow Jackets saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. He's at midfield. He's taken down at the 48. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. Georgia Tech's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Makes it to the 37. Got a first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Up the middle for a nice gain.
A run all the way and got a good jump. Once he got there, He wasn't about to let him slip away either.
From the 34-yard line, it's third down. Slings it to his fullback. And he's taken down at the 26. And Herbie, we got a guy down after that play. The Falcons' running game just took a big hit. Their back went out earlier with that injury, and now they're telling us not going to be able to return today. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. The Falcons had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Pitches back. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. This is the ninth play of the current drive. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Heading for the corner. Touchdown, Falcons. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. Falcons, his quarterback, taken off earlier. Down on the sideline right now. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we'll see him back in the game before the day is over. Tackle made at the 15. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. To the 30. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. That makes it first and 10. First and 10. Ball on their own 36. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. That'll make it second and 7. And he's tackled in the open field. First and 10. Ball on their own 47. Space. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. First down. From the 33-yard line, first down. He makes his way out to about the 12. That makes it first and 10. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line. 2 yards there on the option keeper. Second down and 7. Ball on the 10-yard line. And that sets them up with a first and goal. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
Touchdown, Yellow Jackets. Splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 84-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
You know, this offensive line has done a really good job. But really, I think it's more about the big play ability from the running backs and why we've seen so many big plays from this offense.
He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's on the run. Locked down at the 35. From their own 35-yard line. First down. Zips it to the tailback, incomplete.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Now he tries to buy some time. Slides down. Picks up 5 on the scramble. From their own 40-yard line. Third down. Gets to that quickly. He's tackled around the 45-yard line. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
And he shoved out of bounds at the 25. Pretty good job by the return man there.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Georgia Tech up 7 points. He's going to go for the home run. Doesn't get there. And they just couldn't connect there on the long ball.
Boy, that's one the quarterback wants back. He just had a little too much on that pass.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. Going deep. This one will fall incomplete.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. Put his defense in alignment and a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He airs it out.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
Tackled at the 29-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Makes the catch and look out. Good tackle there in space. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
Now it's 3rd and 6 coming up. Ball on the 32-yard line. To his receiver. Tackle at the 48-yard line. Air Force is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. And he's level at the 40-yard line.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. He goes downtown. Missed him. We played a half of football. Georgia Tech leads 14-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. People say college football is evolving, it's completely an offensive game. Boy, not this one. This one has an old school, hard-nosed, tough feel to it.
Yeah, and it's good. It's kind of refreshing. And I know the younger guys, you like all the points all the time, but it's fun to watch these kind of games because you see two defenses flying around. It looks like there's 12 or 13 guys on that side of the football making big plays, making big hits, holding the offenses down. In a world where we have all the fast-paced, up-tempo, scoring points galore, it's good to see some defenses bow their necks and play some good, pretty good ball.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Brought down at the 35-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Georgia Tech is up 7. Midfield, knocked out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. And they'll get him in the backfield. Positive yardage. That makes it third down now. They need to get it down to the 37. Slings it out there, incomplete. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And down he goes at the 32-yard line. From their own 32-yard line, it's first down. Play action. Defense coming. He dives and he'll be marked down. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Interesting call here, tossing it to the fullback. He's not a usual suspect on plays like that.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 47.
Got an opening.
And they make the stop around the 42-yard line. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. From the 31-yard line, first down. The Falcons quarterback down there on the sideline, he was injured earlier. He means so much to this team. And right now, it looks like he's maybe going to be able to get back in the game. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, so we'll hope so. This is the eighth play of this drive. Third and five situation. Ball on the 26-yard line. Zips it to the back. He's knocked out of bounds around the 14-yard line. And this is the 10th play of the drive. And they can smell the end zone. They'll knock him down for a loss.
But the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. Offense is down by seven, so this is a very big third and goal. They're on the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Air Force. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
The defense has to come out and make a stop on the next drive so this offense can get to work again. They aren't out of this game yet.
Will be tied with the extra point. He makes the PAT. Air Force kick this one off. It's fielded at the 2. They'll bring him down at the 26-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. He makes his way to about the 42. From their own 42-yard line, first down.
Line 36. pitches back. He's pushed out of bounds
at about the 27-yard line. So at the end of the third quarter, 14 apiece.
Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Pitches in, and he's got a lane. And they push him out right around the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, it's first down. And he keeps it on the option play and picks up six.
That'll make it second and four.
It's a nice read by the quarterback to keep the ball and pick up some yardage.
First and goal, fourth quarter, all tied up. What's it going to be? And he's tackled around the 3-yard line. A gain of 3 yards by the fullback.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there. Here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. He didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
And he adds the extra point. Georgia Tech is lining up to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
They'll work the right side. He's to the 40. He gets hit out of bounds.
Around the 48-yard line.
From their own 48-yard line. First down. He's taken down at the 49.
Just under three to go in regulation.
He's taken down at the 48. From the 48-yard line, it's third down.
Here we go. Green and eight.
And a quick throw. They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line. Pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
Down around the 33-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33-yard line.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
25-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. The offense is going to stay on the field and try to convert another fourth down. Just over a minute left.
Here we go. Green 9-10.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. 10th play of the drive. Out to about the 14-yard line. The Falcons will use their first time out of the half. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Here we go. Lighting.
Air Force is going to have to use their second time out of the half. And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain in a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Touchdown, Falcons. In the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first? They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he converts the extra point. Just under a minute left in the fourth quarter, and this game hasn't failed to disappoint. It's all tied up at 21. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he's taken down at the 33.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. He's scrambling. Tackle at the 40. We have less than a minute to go. Chucks it downfield. Incomplete. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. And here we are. We played four quarters, and we still don't have a winner, so we go to overtime. Makes it out to about the 16. That brings a short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Gets to about the 14-yard line. Pitches it. He's got the corner. Gets out to around the 6. Never want to see a kid down on the field after a play. Not sure what happened, but hopefully it's nothing serious. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
This is what it's it's all about in college football. I score, now we'll see if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. From the 25-yard line, first down. He zips it. Oh, he drops it.
That makes it second and 10.
What a play, and that is first and goal. And goal from the five. They're knocking on the door. Touchdown, Air Force. The extra point to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT.
Offenses did well responding to the early pressure of overtime. Now we'll see who can play better defense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's looking for six. The defender had it and then dropped it. Yard line.
That makes it third and goal.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Ready! Ryan 68! Check, check! Hammerhead! Screen!
Here's the halfback on the screen. He's brought down in the open field. He gets it up, and he got it. The kicker does his job, but now it's up to the defense. They're going to have to stand up and make a big stop.
This is very nerve-wracking for both teams because now anything can happen on this second series of overtime.
First and 10, ball on the 25.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Here's an opening. Knocked out of bounds at the 10. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Roger, Roger. Mike for six. Mike for six.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That brings him second and goal.
So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. Georgia Tech 34, Air Force 31. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.